Hello friends, let's try to understand useMemo and see how we can improve the performance of React applications. It's really important to know memoization because, as you know, React renders a lot. Whenever a state changes, the whole component re-renders. And not only the main component, if you have any child components, they re-render also. So I'm gonna show you how to cache expensive functions and child components to make your applications faster. Okay, let's say we have a text state and we can change that text using this input. It means whenever I update the text, my component re-renders. Like that. But I want to write here the number which is the sum of all numbers from 0 to 100 million. And it's quite an expensive calculation. As you can see, there is a function. The number starts from 0 and we add here each number from 1 to 100 million and it returns the total number. Let's create here a variable and call this function. And I want to show this on the screen. Okay, it's here, but if I try to write here something, as you can see, there is a delay. It's not showing what I write immediately. The reason is when I change the text input, it re-renders the component, and when the component re-renders, it calls this function again and again. But it doesn't make sense to call this expensive function again, because this number never changes. This is where we should use the useMemo hook. I will say useMemo. It comes from React and works like a useEffect hook. It takes a callback function and a dependency array. In this case, we won't have any dependency because this number never changes, always the same number. And here, I will write the function that will be remembered. As you can see, even if we re-render the component, this function is not being called again. And this number is in the memory right now. Let's see how we can use a dependency. Right now, instead of this number, I will take a number from a user. So we can give any number here. To do that, I will create a number state. And to update this state, I will create another input. Like that. So I can pass this number here. And as you can see, there is a warning. Because we should write this number as a dependency. It means this function will run at the beginning and after it will run again only when this number changes. Let's see. As you can see, the function is running, but if I change this text, it will not run again because the number is still the same. Let me show you another use case of useMemo. Actually, I've already explained this in the useEffect video, but I will just quickly recap. Let's say we have name, age and country states. I will create here a user type that indicates whether the user is underage or not, and a US citizen or not. You might think that, okay, this is not an expensive calculation, and also I have three inputs here, and user type uses two of them, so it will be updated very often. In this case, I don't need to use useMemo. Yes, you are right, but you should be aware that this is an object. It means when you re-render the component, this object will not be the same again. What I mean by that? Let's create a useEffect. And whenever user type changes, I will write user type has changed. Right now, when we update the age or country, the user type changes. But when I update this name, it's changing again. Because two different objects with the same content are not equal in JavaScript. So even if the age and the country don't change, on every render, a new object is being created. Nothing is changing inside, but the object references are different. If you don't know why this is happening, I recommend you to watch the useEffect video. I explained there in more detail, and in that video there was a similar example. And one solution was to wrap this variable with a useMemo hook. Right now, it depends on only age and country. So it will not change on every render. So remember, If you have an object or array variable that you need to use as a useEffect dependency, you can wrap it with a useMemo hook. Okay, right now we know how to memoize values, but what about components? Again, we have a text here to re-render our component, and this time we have a child component. And this component is really expensive to re-render. It can have many functions inside, or it can fetch thousands of rows of data, or maybe it has a large table here, whatever it might be. Basically, we shouldn't call this component unnecessarily. But here, when we render the parent, it re-renders also. To prevent this, we can memoize this component using React.memo. In this case, it will not re-render again and again. Okay, we know how to use useMemo for values and React.memo for components, and they drastically increase the performance of our apps. So if they make our apps faster, we should wrap every variable with useMemo and every component with React.memo, right? Well, the answer is no. It's one of the most common mistakes every beginner makes. They tend to use them everywhere because they believe that everything is better than re-rendering. But what they don't understand is memoization is not for free. Everything you use them is going to temporary memory. So if you use more memoization than actually needed, it might cause some problems. That's why I especially use this word everywhere. If the calculation is not that expensive, most probably you don't need them. And believe me, in most cases, there are smarter solutions that you can use. For example, here. Instead of using React.memo, you can basically separate the components. So I will create here a form component and update the state here. Let's import this here, and that's all. But what about if we have to use this state for the parent div? It's inside the form right now, and we cannot use this state as an ID, for example. Let's take everything back and use the state here. Actually, let's change this state to the background color. It makes more sense, I think. And I will change the background color of this parent div using this state. Like that. So how we can prevent re-rendering this expensive component? Basically, I will create here a background provider or whatever you name it. And this component will be independent from the expensive component. So it can include any component as a child. Let's delete this and write the provider and pass the expensive component as a child. And as you can see, it works as we expected. So what happens here is, when the background color changes, this provider re-renders, but since the children prop is still the same, it gets from the main component, React doesn't visit that component again. And here, as I mentioned, it's not an expensive calculation and it will change very often. So instead of useMemo, we can change the useEffect dependency and write every single object property instead of the object itself. As you can see, there are some alternatives to memoization. It's important to know them because React warns us it's not guaranteed that your memoization will work in any case. So it's better to try other alternatives first. If it's not enough to solve your problems, then use memo. And the same thing for the use callback hook, but I will explain that hook in another video. By the way, let me know which React memo or React feature you want to see in the future. Maybe in the next video we can create a decent project with what we have learned in the past 4 videos, and it will be a good opportunity for you to see how they are used in a real-world project. Okay, that's all. If you learned something new today, please like the video. You can support Lama Dev by using the link in the description below or joining the channel. Don't forget to follow Lama Dev's social media accounts. I hope I will see you in the next tutorial. Goodbye.